Good morning, friends. I am Surya Agarwal, and you are watching your favorite YouTube channel, Gardening is My Passion. Today, friends, I am going to show you my overview of my rose garden. And this is the, you can see, these are the all the bloom here. Lots of hundreds and hundreds of flowers here. And today is the 5th January 2019. Today is the 5th January 2019, and I am showing you the roses here, the growth of the roses, the sizes of the roses. You can see around more than around 3 inches size, 3 to 4 inches size diameter. All are roses here. You can see the color here and the shapes and size here. These are the flowers, more than 3 inch, 4 to 5 inch diameter. All are the hundreds and hundreds of flowers. You can see these are the full of bloom. So friends, many of the viewers and subscribers ask me how to get these kinds of bloom. These are the, you can see hundreds of all these buds are here, flower buds are here, and you can see these are the flowers here. And if you want to participate in any kind of flower show, how to prepare your pots of these kinds of flower, you can get for the getting prizes in the flower show. All these are, I am giving you all the schedule of the date wise, and in India it is in West Bengal, Kolkata. This is in the north or eastern part of the India if you are there, and I am giving you the date schedule, what to do, where to do, and you just write it down, note it down, how to do it, how to measure it, and you can get this kind of blooms. So just starting with the, please start your pruning, hard pruning at the time of 15th to 30th October. Say for, you have to hard prune it at the 20th October, you have to hard prune it, and the plants will be, all the plants will be pruned it totally, and keep the plants up to 3 feet, 2.5 feet to 3 feet height tall. All you have to prune it, 45 degree angle, total hard pruning at the 20th of October in around India, Indian subclimate. Just hard prune it at 20th October, and this kind of bloom you can get in around 2 months. It will take the processing, all this, and just prune it. Have a look at the video when I was in just 2 months back. I am getting all the hard pruned here. Have a look, and I am coming it back. Thank you. This methodology, starting here, and now this part, and again this part. All the cuttings are done here. And once you are done with all the cuttings, what needs to do is to take some antifungal powder, maybe sap or babistin or bleatox, any type of contact fungicide you can use here. And here I have taken here some fungicide here I have used, and just taking water to make it a paste. This is the paste I have made here. And what I'll do now, wherever the cuttings are done, just add here so that no infection occurs here. And once you do it, the plants will not die due to fungal attack. And second procedure I am showing you, just make a solution of it and spray it over all the plants. These are all done, and I am showing you how to spray the antifungal powder. I am using antifungal powder. Here I have taken some antifungal powder mixed 2 to 4 gram per liter. I have mixed here and spray it, drench it total with the plants here. All the plants, you use it so that you can spray it here totally, and there will be no infection and plants will not die at all. So this is the system to use, and this you have to do only once only. So friends, after pruning it hard, you have to just apply fungicide, contact or systemic fungicide, especially the soft type of fungicide, 2 gram per liter or 3 gram per liter, and spray it, drench the plant totally, and especially on the cut portion you have to apply this fungicide, and just keep it. And on that day you have to apply some of the rose food. Just have a look how I use the rose food and all. These are the, you have to till the land here. You have to make here all the till, the loosen the land around 1 feet around, and you have to apply the rose food. Just have a look. I have applied it just after the pruning. I have applied some of the rose food there and some fungicide, and have a look, and I'll come back again. Thank you. All the soil around 4 to 5 inch, and all the around 1 feet. And now I'll be using rose food powder, mainly 6:12:6. That is, this is the rose food powder. This contains NPK of around, this is totally organic, means vermicompost or compost or countdown compost, many type of compost they are used, and they have made this rose food powder. This is from Levix, and you can get online from Flipkart or Amazon. Lots of rose food powders are available. Now I'll be using, this is some compounds, and I'll be using here today. I'm using all the rose food powder easily available, 6:12:12 here, and now I am watering it. So friends, after 10 days, that is around 30th October, what you will do, just till the land again, and all the loosen the soil around 1 feet around the plant, the stem of the plant there, and then use some of the mixer fertilizer available in the market, and this contains lots of organic and inorganic food, especially the all the bone meal, stera meal, and horn meal, and super phosphate, NPK, potash, these kind of mixtures are there, around 7 materials are there, and apply 100 gram per, if the plants in the garden, 100 gram per plant, or if you are using it in pot, use 50 gram per pot. So this you will be applying in 30th October, and after 10 days of pruning. So just losing this, I'll have a look how I am using it, and come back again. How here, this is the schedule. Thank you. Around 1 feet from the base, from the 1 feet from the base, and this is area. Now I'll be mixing around 100 gram of organic and inorganic fertilizers, mainly some of the bone meal, stera meal, horn meal, some of the super phosphate, NPK, potash. These are the some count of things here, and I will be mixing here 2 fistful of here fertilizer. Around 100 gram each. These are all. Now I am filling it here with the soil here. And make it a mound here, so that the upper portion is here. This is a high, so that no water is stored here. So this is here. So friends, this is the time to water it. So friends, after 10 days, that is around 10th November, what we'll do, use some of this, again use rose food, and that is some organic rose food mixture of NPK, and this contains 5:10:5 or 6:12:6 NPK, this is rose food, and 20 gram per plant. Just loosen the soil there, and use, if the plant is in the garden, use 20 gram per plant in the garden, and if you are using in the pot, use 10 gram per plant, use this rose food, and again use 10 gram of potash in each plant here in the garden, and 5 gram per plant if it is in the pot. Just use it and just water the plant, and don't forget to mount the soil here, so that the water is not retained here, so plants doesn't like sitting on the water. So these are the, should be highly mounted, so that the power water does not retain, and don't forget to water the plant each and every day. And now after 20 days, what I will do now, again using, I will be tilling the soil from here. And I will be using rose food powder. And if I am using rose food powder here, I will be using around 1 fistful is enough for these big plants in the garden. So this will do all your work. And if you are using in the pot, you can use around 5 to 10 gram or 1 teaspoonful is enough. This rose food powder, you can have it from many of the Flipkart or Amazon, all there are. And next, what to do is around 10 gram of potash. This is the chemical potash, and you can spray here, and this is the final
fertilizing your plants, nothing to do. And if you are using in pots, just use 5 gram is enough for in your one pot, and nothing you have to do. And next, what to do is to water the plants. And this is all, and as you can see, this is all done, and this needs lots of watering. The rose plants needs lots of watering. You have to keep it up, and every morning you have to water properly.
So this will, and if you continue to water it, and you treat it 20 days only, and this will be the result. After 2 months, you can get these are the results, and after 20th December, you can get this kind of result here. I guarantee you, they maintain you, and if the insect attack is there, you just to apply any kind of insecticide or such kind of chemicals you can apply. But here, it did not use any kind of insecticide here, there was no insect attack. So this is the result here, and you can also get such kind of plants. And I tell you, these are all the English roses, grafted English roses. These are not the desi roses, these are all English roses. And you can get the colors here, beautiful bloom, and hundreds of our buds here. So these are the all the schedule of maintaining the rose plants. And if you do it, I guarantee you to get such kind of blooms, or even better blooms you can get there if you maintain them properly. So hope you understood all the process of getting the maximum bloom from the roses, and this is the authentic manner to get the blooms here, and you can participate in any flower show competitions also. So hope you enjoyed the video. If you like the video, please give it a like, give it a thumbs up. If you want to share, please share with your near and dear ones. If you are very new to my channel, please subscribe my channel. I am going to give a lot about the flowering and floring and all. Thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. So nice of you. Thank you.